In this lecture, I am going to discuss about the unilateral transform, the continuation of the Laplace transform. Sometimes they may ask, so the unilateral transform x of t or x of s is equal to 0 to infinity. If you see bilateral transform, it is minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus st into dt. This is x of s for bilateral. But unilaterally start from 0 to infinity and we have to integrate this x of t into e power minus st into dt. So example, if I take x of t is equal to e power minus a of t plus 1 into u of t plus 1. So we know that t plus 1 will start from the minus 1, right? But if I take bilateral, it should be e power minus a t into u of t 1 by s plus c, real of s is greater than minus a. Then if there is a shifting, so I will get e power s. But if I take unilateral transform, it will start from 0 to infinity and we have to integrate this one, e power minus of a t into e power minus a into e power minus st. If I take e power minus a common and we have to integrate e power minus a t minus st, so e power minus s plus a by t by minus of s plus a, so we will get e power minus a by s plus a, real of s is greater than minus a, is a ROC, region of convergence, then only it will be finite value. If you see bilateral, we are getting e power s by s plus a, but if I see unilateral, e power minus a by s plus a, there is a difference between unilateral and bilateral. So remember, unilateral the integration start with 0 to infinity, bilateral it will start from minus infinity to infinity. Next, there are some different properties compared to bilateral. All other properties like linearity, time shifting, everything will be same, but only some parameters, integration in the s domain. If x of t is Laplace transform is x of s, x of t by t is Laplace transform is s tends to infinity x of s into ds, right? Remember this point. If x of t Laplace transform is x of s, if I divide x of t by t, I have to integrate x of s, the limits are s tends s to infinity. So this is the example, g of t is equal to 1 by t sin omega t into u of t. We know that for sin omega t ut, the Laplace transform is omega by s square plus omega square. Now there is a time, dividing x of t by t, so I have to integrate this to s to infinity omega by s square plus omega square ds. So we know that formula, a by s square plus a square integration ds is equal to 1 by a tan inverse s by a. There is a formula, or also we can say, sorry, this is 1 by s square plus a square. So omega is common, so 1 by omega tan inverse of s by omega, s tends to infinity. If I substitute limit, I will get tan inverse infinity pi by 2 minus tan inverse s by omega, s in place of s only s will come. So the Fourier transform is, Laplace transform is pi by 2 minus tan inverse s by omega. So this also can be written cot inverse of s by omega also, right? So you can remember this. That is, so two more properties, differentiation in the time domain. X of t is x of s. If I differentiate x of t d by dt, I will get s into x of s minus x of 0 minus what is the previous value. But if I see the bilateral, if it is a d by dt x of s, x of t, I will get only s into x of s. I will not get minus of x of 0 minus. That is the main difference in differentiation in time domain in unilateral transform, right? If it is a d square xt by dt square, it will become s square into x of s minus s into x of 0 minus, that is previous value, minus x dash of 0. So we will get two initial conditions here if it is a differentiation in square term. Similarly, if there is an integration in the time domain, that is 0 to t x of tau d tau, I will get x of s by s. But if it is minus infinity to t, I will get x of s by s plus, we have to integrate from minus infinity to 0 minus by s also. Similarly, initial value and final value theorem are same, that is x of 0 plus is equal to limit s tends to infinity s into x of s. Final value theorem is x of infinity is equal to limit s tends to 0 into s into x of s. If I know this, I can solve the differential equations also from the mathematics concepts, right? So what is that is, If the question is given like this, solve the second order linear differential equation d square y by dt square 5 dy by dt plus 6 y t plus d by dt of x of t plus x of t. If the initial condition is given, so we have to use the unilateral transform, that is square terms, so we'll get s square into y of s minus s into y of 0 minus y of dash of 0 plus 6 into y of s, this one 6 into y of s we will get, right? If there is a d by dt x of t, so I will get s into x of s minus x of 0 minus plus x of t means x of s. So for d square y by dt square we will get like this, plus for dy by dt I will get 5 of s into y of s minus y of 0 minus. If I substitute y of 0 minus and dy by dt at t equals 0 minus values, I will get the transfer function as like this. So we will get some y of s. So we need to find the question, the input also given, so we have to find y of s. So if I substitute here, I will get y of s as like this. Then I can take the inverse Laplace transform by using the procedure what I explained in the previous lectures. So if I will get like this, so it is simply e power minus 4t, e power minus 2t, e power minus 3t. It's still unilateral transform, so r over c is not required here, only 1 by s plus a, so e power minus a t. So here you will get minus 2t, here I will get minus 3t, etc. So this is about some the Laplace transform concept unilateral. Sometimes they will ask what is a zero input response, zero state response. Zero input response is nothing but the system output when the input is zero, that is x of t equal to zero, and thus it is the results of internal system conditions. So that is like a initial condition. One more is there is zero state response, the system response to external input x of t when the initial conditions are zero. So the total response is equal to zero input response plus zero state response, that is like this. And one more thing, natural response, the response due to poles of the system is called the natural response. Forced response is the response due to the poles of the input is called the forced response of the system. That also you can see, sometimes they will ask this, find the zero input response or zero state response, right? So in the next lecture we will see the Z transform.